Hi everyone, this is Dr. S. Chinnavenkateshwarlu, working as a professor of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Department of ECE. Today topic is the characteristics of operation amplifier. Okay, so here characteristics of operation amplifier. Here we know that our operation amplifier is schematic diagram and block diagram and so on. We have seen, everybody know that one. With reference to this DC characteristics, basically we're having the DC characteristics and AC characteristics. Using this, all are some typical values supposed to have to verify. Here under DC characteristics, input and output offset voltages and currents. After that, we will try to verify the drift. Okay, after that, we will verify that AC characteristics. Under AC characteristics, frequency response, slave rate, and CMRR and PSSR. PSRR, this is under AC characteristics as well as DC characteristics. Okay, within this, in depth of this, we are right to verify that our DC characteristics in input offset voltage, it is followed by VIO. Okay, so input bias current IB and input offset current IOB, IOA, IOI. Yeah, thermal drift. So AC characteristics, we are going to verify that all in the frequency responses. Under this, suppose you have to verify slew rate, other parameters of operational amplifier. Beyond this all AC and DC characteristics, like a differential input resistance, already we have seen that based on this differential amplifier. Here also you have to verify, and other than this, input capacitance, CI, offset voltage adjustment range, and input voltage range, and CMRR, common mode rejection ratio, SVRR, that is supply voltage rejection ratio, or sometimes we have to use that all large signal voltage gain. After that, we will have to verify that output voltage swing, output resistance or not, and supply voltages. And these are all considered with in terms of particular RI, CI, CMRR, SVRR, R naught and SI, SC, and so on. This is under other parameters of operation amplifier. Okay, other than this, all are we have to verify that on power consumption, gain bandwidth, product, and so on. So, within this, consider that our input offset voltage VIO, where VIO is the differential input voltage that exhibits between the two input terminals of an operation amplifier. Yeah, in operation amplifier, we are having the two input terminals like inverting and non-inverting. So, with reference to this, without any external input applied. Yeah, in other words, it is the amount of the input voltage, yeah, that should be applied between the two input terminals in order to force the output voltage to zero. Okay, let's consider noted that output offset voltage due to the input offset voltage VIO as VOO, like this, the output of offset voltage VOO is caused by mismatching. Okay, so mismatching between these two input terminals. What are the input terminals? Already we know that all input terminal, based on that, sometimes it is caused by mismatching that between two input terminals. So in depth of this all, input offset voltage VIO. Within this, you have to consider that op amp, okay, using this operation amplifier with input offset voltage in op amp. But that in inverting terminal, non inverting terminal is connected with this all, where inverting terminal is connected to the VIN, okay, and with the help of this polarity, negative and positive. So, non inverting terminal is connected to the ground. Here, minus VCVE and plus VCC. With reference to this, where V input is equal to 0 volts, so that load resistance is inserted using this all simple diagram. Figured, we can consider that input offset voltage in operation amplifier. For this, even though all the components are integrated on the same chip, yeah, it's because of the op-amp is the monolithic. This is the single stone. like you can consider this a chip or IC, integrated circuit. It is not possible to have two transistors in the input differential amplifier stage with the what you call exactly the same characteristics. Yeah, this means that the collector current in these two transistors are not equal, which causes differential input output voltages from the input first stage. Okay, the output of the first stage is applied by following the stages and possibly aggregated by more mismatching them. Okay, within this, input VIO is extended with this, the output the operation amplifier with offset voltage is compensated. Yeah, the compensated network is available using this. The compensating network consists of potentiometer RA and resistor RB and RC. So to establish relationship between VIO and supply voltage, so within this supply voltages, easily can verify that the compensated network, it consists of the potentiometer RA and resistor RB and RC. With the help of these, to establish a relationship between VIO and supply voltages. For this and compensated components, first Thevenized the circuit looking back into the RA from point T. So the maximum Thevenin's equivalent resistor R maximum it occurs when the swiper is not the center of the potentiometer. So easily can observe this all interpretation of amp with offset voltage compensation network. So as per the circuit diagram, the composite network, it consists of potentiometer RA, resistors RB and RC. You have to consider this as a simple op amp with the offset voltage compensating network. So with the help of this all network is easy to consider the maximum Thevenin's equivalent resistor resistance R maximum. Okay, so within this, so we have to consider the Thevenin's equivalent for R maximum. Okay, with the help of this, R maximum is equal to R by 4 with reference to the circuit. And coming to this second figure where it is mentioned the plus VCC and minus VCC in terms of the RA with the T, where V maximum is equal to the supply voltage plus VCC. And after Thevenin's equivalence for the V maximum, so where RA V plus plus R minus V with V maximum minus V. So we using this all that. This equation supply voltages VCC and minus V are equal in the magnitude. So therefore easily can verify this all. So mathematical relation. Let us denote that magnitude by voltage V, thus V maximum is equal to V. So by using this all Thevenin's equivalent for R maximum easily can interpret. Next we redraw the compensating network using the maximum Thevenin's voltage and resistance as per this Thevenin's equivalent for R maximum. Within this we have minus V and plus VCC in terms of the RA. So where V maximum is equal to plus VCC and so on. Okay, apply this voltage divider rule above figure, or we have to consider the final above figure, or we will expect it expected. We get after applying this R maximum, T and RB and V2 and RE. Compensating the network with the maximum Thevenin's voltage and resistance. So we have to calculate that VT, where V2 is equal to that RC by R maximum plus RB plus RC into V maximum. Okay, like this where V2, but here already we know that where V2 has been expressed as a function of the maximum Thevenin's voltage, V maximum and maximum Thevenin's resistance, but the maximum value of V2 can be equal to VIO. So how we are agreeing this one? There is a evidence that VIO, since because of where V1 minus V2 is equal to VI0. So that means this is the interpretation using that in terms of the VE after applying the compensating network with the maximum Thevenin's voltage and resistance. This equation, this equation becomes VIO is equal to RC by R maximum plus RB plus RC into V maximum. So assume that where RB greater than R maximum, it's greater than RC, where R maximum is equal to RA by 4. Like this, easily can interpret. Directly we are right to verify that all in terms of the V2 as well as VIO. Okay, using this assumption, R maximum plus RB plus RC is equal to RB. Easily can prove that if you are using that all problematic point, easily you can justify that where RB value, RB, RA by 4 and so on. So, therefore, this easily can analyze. So, that VIO is equal to RC by RB into V maximum. So, where V maximum, we know that one, where V maximum is equal to VCC mod VCC is equal to mod minus V. We know that all importance of the mod. Where VI 0 is equal to RC by RB into V, let us now examine the effect of V in VIO in amplifiers with the feedback. So, where it is concerned that our feedback, if you want to consider that one, the non-inverting and inverting amplifier with the feedback are, yeah, if it is available, we will try to verify that. After that, we will try to determine, try to calculate, to determine the effect of VIO in each case. We have to consider that closed loop non-inverting or inverting amplifier. So, we have to reduce the input voltage V into the zero. So, using these all constraints, we have to consider this simple circuit diagram. Non-inverting, inverting amplifier with the feedback are what you call shown in figure, where Vin is equal, approximately equal to 0 volts. R1 is specified that V minus plus VCC, and this you can try to calculate the VO. So that is 1 plus RF by R1 into Vin. So like this, we need to calculate. With Vin reduces to 0, the circuit of both, once it is Vin is 0, what happens? The circuit will be changed. So how it is changed? Non-inverting and inverting amplifier are the same as the circuit. Okay, using this particular consideration or condition, what you call the inverting amplifier are the same as the circuit in figure. The internal resistance Rin of the input signal, so voltage is negligibly small. Okay, as per this figure. So the non-inverting input terminal is connected to the ground. Therefore, assume that the voltage V1 at the input terminal to be 0. This of the using this all constraints, you can investigate that Vin versus VIO and so on. The voltage V2 at the inverted input, so terminal can be determined by applying this voltage divider rule. Using this all voltage divider rule, mathematically it is observed where V2 is equal to R1 into VOO by R1 plus RF. Like this, VOO is equal, we know that from that above equation, VOO easily can calculate, VOO is equal to what you call R1 plus RF into RF by R1 into V2. So, since we know that VIO is equal to, so mod V1 minus V2 and V1 is equal to 0 volt. So, where VIO is equal to 0 minus V2 is equal to V2, the time easily can calculate that VOO. That finalize that VOO is equal to R1 plus RF by R1 into VIO is equal to AOO into VIO. So, next parameter is in terms of that input bias current, it is followed by IB. Input bias current IB as the average value of the base current entering into the input terminal of an operational amplifier. Okay, as per this, where IB1 is equal to DC bias current flowing into the non-inverting terminal, because of you have to consider that block diagram. So where IB2 is equal to DC bias current flowing. Using this all interpretation, is going to observe that all input bias current. Okay, where IB2 is equal to DC bias current flowing into the internal inverting terminal. Actually, the input current IB1 and IB2 are the base bias currents of the two transistors in the input. So, input of that differential amplifier stage of the operational amplifier. Earlier, we have seen that, we know that the block diagram of differential amplifier, block diagram of what you call operational amplifier, in that case, that the differential amplifier is there. Using the solar inverting terminal, actually, this input currents IB1 and IB2 are the base bias currents of the two transistors in the input differential amplifier stage of the operational amplifier. Even though both of the input character transistor are identical, what happens? Here, it is not possible to have IB1 and IB2 exactly equal to each other because of the internal imbalance between the two inputs. Okay, like this, we have to consider this all input bias current in operational amplifier. So, after this, you can calculate that IB is equal to IB1 plus IB2 by 2. Okay, like this, the value of the input bias current is very small in the range of few to the few hundred nanoamperes. You have to consider this value. So, even though very small in the input bias current can cause a significant output offset voltage in circuits using relatively large feedback resistor. Okay, the feedback resistor is very small. What happens? If it is using this simple circuit, using a relatively large feedback resistor, so hence precautions must be taken to minimize it. Due to this, let us assume that where IB1 is equal to IB2 is equal to IB1. This is the first assumption. So, first we obtain that expression for the output offset voltage caused by the input bias current IB in the inverting and non-inverting amplifier, and then devise some scheme to eliminate or minimize it. After that, go for next to the non-inverting or inverting amplifier with the Vin is equal to 0 is redrawn. So, using this all constraints, suppose we have to verify change that all set to time. Like this, it is easily can identify that where Vin is equal to 0 volts. It is assumed the time, what are the effect with this I1, IB1 and IB2 in between that R1 and V1. So, where it is R1 and R0 and plus VCC and minus VE with the RF, that feedback resistance RF. So, it is flowing this flow of current. Easily can measure the V0 in IB in terms of AV, EDI is equal to AV, and it should be normalized this. Okay, in the above figure, the input bias current IB1 and IB2 are flowing into the non-inverting and inverting input leads. Check it that as per the circuit. So, the non-inverting terminal is connected to the ground, isn't it? So, within this, therefore, the voltage V1 is equal to 0. So, after that, directly we can satisfy this output of the voltage due to the input bias current in a non-inverting or inverting amplifier. Okay, like this, the control voltage source A into VI0 is equal to 0, since VI0 is equal to 0 volt is assumed. So, for this case, with the output resistance, R0 is negligible. Negligibly small because of using this constraint. The right end of the RF is essential or at ground potential, that is resistor R1 and RF are in the parallel and the bias current IB2 flows through them. Therefore, the voltage at the inverting terminal is easily can investigate. So, using this all, we require writing the what you call node voltage equation for V2. This is one way we get IB2. So, after that, where output voltage in IB, it is also equal to the output offset voltage due to the input bias current. Where we know that in input resistance of the operational amplifier. Okay, rearrange this above equation, we get what you call according to this, easily can calculate that V2, where V2 is equal to R1 parallel RF into IB2, it is also equal to what you call R1 into RF by R1 plus RF into IB2 as per your diagram using this all constraints. Okay, so the time you have to consider to where I1 plus I2 is equal to IB2. With reference to that, easily can substitute this this value, I1 value and I2 value. So, easily can observe that one V2 by R1. So, finalize that, rearranging this above equation, we will get that VOIB by RF is equal to V2 of, because of that all R1, RF and RA, because of that, V2 is common for that 1 by R1 plus 1 by Rf plus 1 by Ri input resistance. Okay. So, since input resistance is approximately equal to infinity, that means 1 by Rin is equal to 0 diamonds. Therefore, so output voltage and base current by feedback resistor is equal to V2 of 1 by R1 plus 1 by Rf. Yeah, substituting this equation of the V2 in the above equation, we have so output voltage in the base current is equal to what you call R1 into Rf into Ib2 into what you call Ib2 by R1 plus Rf into R1 by R1 plus Rf by R1. So therefore, that V output voltage VO Ib is equal to feedback resistor into Ib2. Okay. So, like this, even though very small in the input bias current can cause a significant output offset voltage in circuits using relatively large feedback resistors. So, hence, precautions must be taken into minimizing. Using this all interpretation, let us assume that Ib1 is equal to Ib2 is equal to Ib. First, we obtain the expression for the output offset voltage caused by the input bias current IB in the inverting and non-inverting amplifiers and then devise some schemes to eliminate or minimize it. Okay. Like this, VOIB is equal to feedback resistor into base current. Okay. So, output offset voltage due to the input bias current, we have to devise a scheme at the input which the voltage V1 can be made equal to V2. So, as per this analysis, you can observe this with reference to we have what you call here V2. V2 is equal to R1 parallel with Rf into Ib2 is equal to what you call R1 into Rf by R1 plus Rf into Ib2. So, where V2 is equal to what you call R, so Rf into what you call Ib2, where Rp is equal to R1 into Rf by R1 plus Rf. So, from this, this equation implies that we must express voltage V1 at the non-inverting input terminal as a function of Ib1 and some specific resistor. Okay. So, this can be accomplished as follows. The input bias current does not produce any voltage at the non-inverting terminal because of this terminal is directly connected to the ground. If it is not connected to the ground, what happens? So, this cannot be accomplished as follows. Like the input bias current does not, the bias current produces any voltage at the either inverting or non-inverting terminal. Now, it is varies. But as per this, all mathematical interpretation now, this can be accomplished as follows. The input bias current does not produce any voltage at the non-inverting terminal because this terminal is directly connected to the ground. Okay. Due to this, if you could connect the proper value of the resistor, okay, in the non-inverting terminal, the voltage V1, so would be easily can investigate. That means where V1 is equal to so R into Ib1, we have voltage V1 equal to V2, right hand side of the equation. And so using this all previous equation must be equal to that. This is where Rp into Ib2 is equal to Rym into Ib1. Now, if Ib1 and Ib2 are equal, so our equation implies that Rp is equal to Rp into Ib2 is equal to Rym into Ib1. Due to that, for using this equation, easily can calculate this. This is ready to calculate that where Rom is equal to R1 into Rf by R1 plus Rf. Like this, mathematically ready to interpret. Okay. So, using this all R, that is going to be that previous method, previous parameter. Now, we ready to calculate the input offset current. Input offset current, IOI. Input offset current. So, input offset current, though for an ideal operational amplifier, the input impedance is infinite. it is not so practically. So the IC drawn current from the source, however small it may be, this called input offset current, input offset current, IO. The output input offset current, IOI, is the difference between the current into the inverting and non-inverting terminals of a balanced amplifier. Usually you can observe that by using a simple figure, like here. Okay, as per this previous output offset voltage, VOIO, caused by the input offset current, where input offset current is equal to mod IB1 minus IB2. As per this circuit, IB1 minus IB2, is you can verify that input offset current IOI. Okay. So, where IOI is equal to that mod of IB1 minus IB2. So, the IOI for the 741 IC is 200 nanoampere maximum. Because of, you know, that it is the operation of the monolithic IC. Okay. It is a single stone. We are having that specific what you call IC number 741. C is it's around IOI. Is 200 nanoampere maximum value. So, as the matching between the two input terminals is improved, okay, the difference between IB1 and IB2 becomes what you call smaller. That is the input output current value decreases what you call further for a precision op amp 741 IC. So, input offset current is 6 nanoampere. So, where in this case, for this case, next parameter is the thermal drift. It is assumed that the parameter of the input output voltage, so IB, base current, input offset current are constant for the given operation amplifier. Yeah, that given operational amplifier is considered that 741C. However, in practice, the value of the bias current, and offset voltage changes with measure one is it is reflected with the change in the temperature. This is a measure. Other thing is change in the supply voltage. This is normally we know that the supply voltage from plus VCC and minus VE. We know the voltage range from that plus or minus 50 volts, 0 to plus or minus 50 volts. Third one is the time. This is the in terms of the practice, the values of the bias current, and offset voltage changes with respect to either it is change in temperature or change in supply voltages. And time. So among these, the most serious variation in the values of input offset voltage, base current and input output current is due to the change in the temperature, the average rate of the change of the input offset voltage. Okay, so the average rate of change of input offset voltage for unit change in temperature is called thermal voltage drift. And you can consider it is denoted by what you call it is expressed in terms of by the concept. You can also define the thermal drift in the input offset current and input bias current as follows. You have to consider that one. If it is, we will try to expect this one express delta VIO by delta T. Okay. So, like this, where delta IO by delta T is thermal drift in the input offset current PA in terms of the degree centigrade. Delta IB by delta T is thermal drift in the input bias current. Let's consider this one. An operational amplifier carefully nulled at 25 degrees centigrade may not remain so. So, when the temperature rises to 35 degrees centigrade, this is called drift. Okay, we know that after we have seen the thermal and in terms of thermal drift, using the temperature variation, now it is reflected. This you can identify that drift. And op-amp carefully nulled at 25 degrees centigrade up to when the temperature rises 35 degrees centigrade. This is called drift. More than that 35 degrees centigrade. So it's going to verify that practically how it is varies, how it is affected. Now up to this we have verified that DC characteristics. Now we have to consider that next characteristics, AC characteristics, and these AC characteristics in terms of we have to consider only frequency response. Okay. So the gain of an operational amplifier is a complex number that is a function of frequency. You know that. So therefore, at the given frequency, the gain will have a specific magnitude as well as a phase angle. Isn't it? So like this means that the variation in the operating frequency will cause variation in the gain magnitude and its phase angle. Okay, as per this all, gain of the operational amplifier is complex number that is a function of the frequency. Okay, so the manner in which the gain of the operational amplifier responds to different frequencies is called the frequency response. So we have to consider in terms of the AC characteristics, which all are depending upon what you call consideration with the frequency response. Yeah, generally for an amplifier, as the operating frequency increases, what happens? Two affected become more evident. One is the gain in terms of the magnitude of the amplifier decreases, and second one is the phase shift between the output and the input resistance signal increases. Like this, that amplifier as the operating frequency it will increases, what happens? If it is decreases, we'll investigate that. This all aspects are required for verifying this what you call 741 operational amplifier with all ideal characteristics and the practical characteristics are reflected. The phase shift between the output and input signal increases. Like this, in the case of an operational amplifier, the change in the gain and the phase shift as a function of frequency is attributed to the internally integrated capacitors, okay, as well as stray capacitance. You can consider that all condensers. Yeah, these capacitances are due to the physical characteristics of semiconductor devices. You know that all semiconductor devices, with reference to that, the physical characteristics are involved by using these particular devices. The internal construction of the operational amplifier, you know that one, the manner in which the gain of an operational amplifier with the variation in frequency is known as the magnitude plot, and the manner in which the phase shift. Okay, the phase shift changes with the variation in the frequency is known as the phase angle plot. Okay, so the rate of the change of the gain as well as the phase shift of what you call operational amplifier, op-amp, can be changed by using specific components within it. The most commonly used components are verify that all either active component or passive component. Especially specified that commonly, the most commonly used in the components are passive components like resistors, capacitors. Okay, so the network formed by the such a components using this all the passive components and using the operational amplifier and used for the modifying the rate of change of the gain and the phase shift is called the compensating network. So how it is? The phase lag and phase lead are the most commonly used compensating network in the op-amp. Phase lag introduces the negative phase angle and phase leads a positive phase angle. Okay, thus the main purpose of the compensating network is to modify the performance of an op-amp or operational amplifier circuit or the desired frequency range. It is all based on the desired frequency range. It is the target frequency range. Okay. Like this, by controlling its gain and phase shift, so based on the compensating networks, so there are two types of op-amps. One is internally compensated, So it is specified as 741C op amp. Yeah, normally they are using this. This is a popular 741C op amp. And externally compensated, they are using that what you call op amp, that IC number 709C. These are all, it is all based on the compensated network. Okay, either maybe internally compensated or externally compensated. Okay, so mostly that practical aspect, they are using internally compensated. External compensated circuit, somewhat it is specified specific applications. Yeah, in internally compensated op amp, the compensating network is designed into the circuit to control the gain and the phase shift of the amplifier. So this all reflected with the op amp only. So on the other hand, and external compensating components that is resistor or capacitor are added at the designated the terminals in non-compensated operational amplifiers. Need for frequency compensation in practical op amps based on that the frequency variation. Like in frequency compensation is needed in large bandwidth. That is the one aspect. So other one is closed loop gain is desired. That is your desirability. Based on this desirability, the frequency compensation practical op amp circuit is of its importance. So compensating network are used to control the phase shift. Yeah, how we are observing the phase shift, maybe 0, 90, 180, and 270 and 360 and so on. And hence to improve the stability. By using this all control the phase shift, there is a deciding factor of that. So we have to verify that to improve the stability of the device, stability of the circuit, stability of the system. Frequency compensation methods. Yeah. Okay. So the frequency compensation method, one is dominant pole compensation and the second one is pole zero compensation. So using these all two methods, directly you can interpret, directly can decide the factors like so how it is control the phase shift or maybe how it is improve the stability and so on. Now coming to the next slew rate. Okay. So another important frequency related parameter of an op amp is slew rate. Okay, the slew rate is defined as the maximum rate of the change of the output voltage with respect to the time, usually expressed in volts per microsecond. So for example, 1 volt per microsecond slew rate means that the output rises or falls no faster than 1 volt every microsecond. Isn't it? We are right to consider that a slew rate is interpreted, and an ideal slew rate is infinite, which means that op amp's output voltage should change instantaneously in response to the input step voltage. So practical operational amplifier available with slew rates. Okay. So one is from 0.1 volt per microsecond to well about 1000 volts per microsecond. It is a practical op amps available in typical values or specified values slew rates. Okay, the symbolic diagram of op amp is shown. You know that all symbolic diagram, because inverting, non-inverting are V naught in terms of all first pin, second pin, fourth and sixth pin and eighth pin. So eighth pin. Here inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal plus VCC minus VCC output voltage. So this is the output symbolic diagram. Symbol. So 741 is the most commonly used op amp available in IC package. So that's why it is using the monolithic. It is an 8-pin dual in package chip. You know that. All are familiar with this. Due to this one, we are verifying this all. Parameter like DC characteristics as well as AC characteristics. Okay. So other parameter other than this AC and DC characteristics, other parameters are involved in op amp. So the various other important parameters of the op amp are, one is the differential input resistance, already we have seen, it is verified. Rn is the equivalent resistance that can be measured at either the inverting and non-inverting input terminal with the other terminal grounded. So for the 741C, the input resistance is relatively highly, high 2 mega ohm. For some op amp, it may be used to 1000 giga ohm. This is one way. Next, second one is the differential input resistance. Input capacitance Ci is the equivalent capacitance that can be measured at either in the inverting or non-inverting terminal. Inverting terminal with the other terminal connected to the ground as per this symbolic diagram of this. So, a typical value of Ci is 1.4 picofarad for the 741. So, other I see that it will vary that all Ci value. Yeah, the third parameter is offset voltage adjustment range. Here, with reference to the 741 operation amplifier, offset voltage is null. Null capacity. Pin number 1 and 5 are marked offset null for this purpose. It's the dual in, 8 pin dual in IC. You have to consider the same pinout diagram. The pin number 1 and 5 are marked offset null for this purpose. You have learned this third step, offset voltage adjustment range, using this operation, 741 operation amplifier. Yeah, it can be done by the connecting the 10 k ohm part between the 1 and 5 as they shown as per this figure diagram. Yeah, it is mentioned, isn't it? So second pin, third pin, and first pin, fourth pin in terms of the fifth and sixth and seventh, seventh pin is connected plus VCC. Okay, like this. Output voltage we like to verify. This is the op amp offset network. So by varying the potentiometer, where is the potentiometer? It is available that output offset voltage with input ground can be reduced to 0 volts. This is the offset voltage adjustment range, in the range through what you call, which the input offset voltage can be adjusted by what you call varying the 10 k ohm for the 741C. The offset voltage is adjustment. Okay, so that range is, it is specified, the range is plus or minus 50 millivolts. So now next parameter is, this is the major parameter for the, so using, once we are learning, we are studying this operation amplifier, input voltage range and common mode rejection ratio, CMRR. Yeah, input voltage range, the input voltage range is the range of a common mode input signal for which a differential amplifier remains linear. Yeah, specifically, it is observed that all which differential amplifier remains the linear. Okay, it is used to determine the degree of matching between the inverting and non-inverting input terminals, like this. So, for the 741 IC, it's a monolithic, we know that one. The range of the input common mode voltage is plus or minus 13 volts maximum. This means that the common mode voltage applied at the both input terminal can be as high as plus 13 volts or as low as minus 13 volts. Yeah, normally practical, what you call laboratory purpose, electronics laboratory purpose and so on, it is specified that plus or minus 13 volts or maybe some plus or minus 15 volts, but it is specified at plus or minus 13 volts maximum for verifying the input voltage ranges. Okay, but in the practically it is, they are using the plus or minus 12 volts or maybe 13 volts or 15 volts. In the practical aspects, we like to investigate, after that we can decide in the factor that input common mode ratio or maybe or the voltage, that input voltage ranges. Okay, practically we are verifying this, we have to verify this all experiments. User can decide the factor, either maybe plus or minus 12 volts or plus or minus 13 volts or maybe plus or minus 15 volts. Next, come to the next parameter, CMRR, common mode rejection ratio. Yeah, the CMRR is defined as the ratio of the differential voltage gain, it is followed by AD. Okay, to the common mode voltage gain is ACM, where ACM is common mode. Okay, a common mode voltage gain, where therefore the CMRR is AD by ACM. So, for the 741C, CMRR is 90 decibel typically. Okay, the highest, the higher the value of the CMRR, the better is the matching between what you call two input terminal and the smaller in the output common mode voltage is 6. Okay, next coming to the SVRR, supply voltage rejection ratio and a large signal voltage gain. Here, supply voltage rejection ratio SVRR is the ratio of the change in the input offset voltage to the corresponding change in the power supply voltage. So, based on this all SVRR, it is specified in the input offset voltage to the corresponding change in the power supply voltages. This is expressed in delta V by V or in decibels. SVRR can be defined as SVRR is equal to delta into V input offset voltage by delta V. It is mathematically specified, where delta V is the change in the input supply voltage, you know that one, and delta V input offset voltage is the corresponding change in the offset voltage, input offset voltage. For the 741C, SVRR is approximately, it is specified, typical value is 150 micro V by V. If you are using the 741, other IC, it will vary. So, for 741C, SVRR is measured for the both supply magnitudes, increases or decreases simultaneously with the, where R3 is equal to 10 kilo ohm. For the same op amps, SVRR is separately specified as positive SVRR and negative SVRR, large signal voltage gain. It is specified. So, since the op amp amplifier, the operational amplifier, difference voltage between two internal terminal, the voltage gain of the amplifier is defined as what you call, like this, large signal voltage gain. Okay, like this, where therefore voltage gain is, we know that one, output voltage by differential voltage, where A is equal to output voltage by input differential voltage, VID. Because output signal amplitude is much larger than the input signal, the voltage gain is commonly called as large signal voltage gain. Okay, for 741C, is voltage gain is typically it is measured. Next, coming to this output voltage swing, output resistance, output short circuit current. Output voltage swing, the AC output compliance PP is the maximum unclipped peak to the peak output voltage that an op amp can produce. Since the quiescent output is ideally zero, this is the one way, the AC output voltage can swing positive or negative. Okay, this is also indicates the values of the positive and negative, what you call saturation voltages of the op amp operational amplifier. So the output voltage, so never exceed these limits for the given supply voltages plus VCC and minus V as per this 741 op amp symbolic or pinout diagram it is specified. For a 741C, it is plus or minus 30 volts. Coming to the output resistance, R0 is the equivalent resistance that can be measured between the output terminal of the op amp and the ground. It is 75 ohms for the 741C op amp. Okay, output short circuit current in some applications, op amp may drive and load resistance that is approximately zero. Okay, even its output impedance is 75 ohm but cannot supply large currents. So, since op amp is a slow power device and so its output current is limited, this is the major desirability. So, the 741C can supply a maximum short circuit output current of only 25 milliampere. It is specified that all both output voltage swing, output resistance, output short circuit current. It is the major parameter, it will reflected. Yeah, that the supply current is, where it is highest, is the current drawn by the op amp from the supply. For the 741C op amp, the supply current is 2.8 milliampere. Coming to this power consumption, it is a major role for this while you are using the discrete version, IC version. In a discrete version, there is a complexity. Based on this complexity, how it is a complexity, the number of components are increasing. But it is, we are using the IC version, it is a monolithic. It is a single stone based. The power consumption is the amount of power Vin is equal to zero that must be consumed by the op amp in order to operate properly. The amount of power consumed by the 741C is 85 milliwatts. When compared to the discrete version, we will expect more than that. Maybe below and above is observed by the comparing both the discrete as well as IC versions. Next one is the bandwidth product. The gain bandwidth product is the bandwidth of the op amp and the open loop voltage gain is reduced to 1. From open loop gain, Vs frequency graph at 1 MHz shown in the figure, it can be found that 1 MHz for the 741 op amp frequency range, the gain reduces to 1. The mid range, mid band voltage gain is 100, 0, 0 and what you call the gain is and cutoff frequency is 10 Hz. So, an op amp block diagram on specifications, already we know that one. Op amp block diagram, you know that all. This all are we know. In the ideal operation, what you call op amp specifications, the input resistance Rn would be infinite. The output resistance Rout would be zero. The voltage gain Vz would be infinity. The bandwidth, how quickly the output will follow in the input would be infinite. Okay, if the voltages in the two inputs are equal, then the output voltage gain is zero. If the output is not zero, it is said to be have an offset. Like this, as per the block diagram, all specifications will be observed. Okay, so practical operation for characteristics, the op amp gain of the practical op amp is around 7000. Practical op amp as non-zero offset voltage, that is the zero output is obtained for the non-zero differential input voltage only. The bandwidth of practical operational amplifier is very small value. So easily can compare the practical and what you call ideal characteristics. This can be increased to desired value by the applying an adequate negative feedback to the op amp. So, like this practical op amp specification, the output impedance is in the order of the hundreds. This can be minimized by applying the adequate negative feedback to the op amp. Yeah, the input impedance is in the order of the mega ohms only, where the ideal op amp has infinite input impedance. Okay, now in terms of this, easily can calculate the other parameters like DC characteristics of op amp. Input bias current, input offset voltage, thermal drift, or it is verified. So, like this, we can decide the factors using this all characteristics of this DC characteristics of op amp and AC characteristics of op amp, some other parameters like CMRR, okay, SVRR are verified. So, using this all are the what you call mathematical expression or theoretical aspects, we will solve that in some numerical values using some problems or some vertical unsolved problems will continue. Thank you.
Like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.